you can make the argument that the Yankees' deadline trade decision to not go after more pitching might have been the thing that undid their season, right?
Well, you can make that argument, but I mean, it's like hindsight's 20/20. I mean, they still
won. So he's not really liking that.
Yeah. I mean, you can say it's a stupid idea.
I'm good with it.
You won over 100 games.
Right.
So, you know, for the second year in a row. So, I mean, they felt that it wasn't necessary for them to go out and go get that kind of pitching or whatnot. And they were still in the series, you know, just fell behind, you know, and lost.
Ryan Howard with us in studio. So now we have the Astros, and we know what Verlander and Cole have been, and they've been great. But suddenly you have this upstart Nationals team, they're starting pitching in the LCS. I mean, they made the entire Cardinals lineup into pitching, hitting pitchers in the regular season. That's how dominant they are. Can they keep this going?
You know, my biggest concern is how they come back out of this layoff. I think with what the Nationals pitching was able to do to the Cardinals, I've lived it. So I've seen it firsthand. Was absolutely incredible. I mean, they just made Paul Goldschmidt just look completely lost at the plate. My man Dex Fowler, no clue at the dish. So, I mean, it's one of those things right now to where they've had this momentum. They're carrying this momentum. And you got to wonder if that break is going to break that up. Now, we had that same type of situation in 2008 where we had 6 days, they had 7 days. But we were a younger team. We didn't really know any better that, you know, that's supposed to affect us. So Washington could have that same effect to where they're going to be hyped up.
So you said you've been through it. Take everybody in the batter's box, okay, against those pitchers or against a Gerrit Cole and the way he's been throwing. Does it make you change what you normally do because they're pitching so well, or you just try and execute better? What's your mentality?
I mean, really what it is that you're trying to just kind of execute. So what you want to do for the most part is obviously you're wanting to try to see the ball up. You're wanting to try to get something that you can handle. So our motto was we wanted to try to hunt the fastball. But when you have the control that Scherzer has had right now in terms of all of his pitches, fastball, changeup, slider, curveball, and he's throwing them for strikes and he's being able to get the movement that he's getting, the cadences that he's throwing these pitches in are not the same cadence. So when you're going up and you're like, okay, he just threw me a curveball right here. All right, last time he did that, he threw me a slider. And then he comes, I'm looking for a slider, and he throws me a changeup. I don't know what to look for anymore. So I have to, my mindset with those guys is, you know, either I'm having to completely eliminate a couple pitches and say I'm only hunting fastballs or I'm only going to hunt the changeup. And if he throws the slider or the curveball for a strike, then I just have to tip my hat, but I have to stay looking for whatever certain type of pitch I'm going to look for.
Ryan Howard with us here again, 2008 World Series champion with the Phillies. You mentioned a young squad that you guys had there. So put us into that mode now, because the Nats, for all the talk about their pitching, their offense has really been led by dominant performances from Juan Soto this postseason.
No, absolutely. I mean, it's Juan Soto. Everybody stepped up. Howie Kendrick has had a resurgence. I mean, he's out there, and if you watch, he's hunting fastballs. So, I mean, when you look at the Nationals, the momentum that they have right now, as a team, I mean, and looking at kind of how Houston's offense is kind of scuffled going 5-46 in the ALCS, it makes you wonder a little bit, because, you know, from a pitching standpoint, starting pitching standpoint, it's even. It's basically even. I mean, you got Cole and Scherzer. You can pretty much call that a wash.
Right.
You got Verlander and Strasburg, wash. Corbin and Greinke, you might give, you know, the slight edge to Greinke potentially, but then you got Sanchez.
He's been unbelievable.
Dirty Sanchez coming out on the four. And you know, where the Astros may look to potentially go with a bullpen type game in game four, you never know. But it's one of those things to where the Nationals offense has definitely stepped up when they've needed to.
So why do you think then that we're talking about a Astros team? By the way, the Astros, since the beginning of the series, everybody thought this is where the Astros would be. I mean, the Yankees could get there, but they've been the best team going forward. So they are a massive favorite, the highest since the 2007 World Series when the Red Sox eventually swept the Colorado Rockies. But it does feel like, because of that starting pitching you mentioned, I don't think this series is going to be that easy.
No, it's not, especially if the Astros offense doesn't wake up.
Yeah.
It's going to be a lot tougher. And then all of a sudden now it starts to come down to the bullpens, where you give the nod to the Astros bullpen over the Nationals bullpen.
Bryce Harper saying all the right things. you know, leaves Washington, gets all that money and says, I'm cool, I'm not jealous, I'm happy where I am.
Right.
True or not?
You know, it's not, I don't think it's jealousy of saying, oh man, I wish I was in Washington with Washington in the World Series. I think it's maybe the jealousy of, I want to be in the World Series and I want to be in the World Series with the Phillies. I want to be on, you know, I want to be there with the team that I'm with.
Yeah.
You know, it's this, that's just that competitive nature. I don't think he's jealous of that actual team. He just wants his team to be there. I'm sure he's probably happy for some of those guys.
I'm sure he is. But I mean, I talked to Lawyer Malloy right before Super Bowl 38 in Houston. He was cut by the Patriots in like the, after the last game of the preseason and signed with Buffalo. And Buffalo won 31-0 the first game of the year. And then they fell apart and the Patriots went on to the World Series. And I said,
Super Bowl, sorry.
Yeah. Patriots win. But Patriots win the World Series. That would be something.
That would be interesting.
We had him on that Super Bowl week and I said, you kind of feel like they were right to cut you because they were here without you. And he's like, yeah, and that's a tough thing to deal with. So there's got to be part of that for Bryce that's saying, I was there all those years, we couldn't get there, and then I leave and they made it without me.
Yeah, I mean, it's just one of those things of kind of like, man, where was that when I was here type of deal.
Right.
But, I mean, hey, it is what it is. You know, you made your bed, you got to lie in it, and I think he understands that. And, again, he's happy for those guys, but wishes it was him with his current team.
So with the current teams in the World Series, do you have a pick going into this series? Who you're giving the edge to?
Yeah, I mean, I've been riding that Houston train. I'm gonna stick with it. You know, again, for me, it's just their offense has got to wake up. They've got to get it going. You know, Alvarez was 1-for-22, which, you know, from the designated hitter spot, you got to have a little bit more production from that. But then also kind of waiting and seeing what happens with Washington. And how they can respond if there's any rust or anything like that coming out of, you know, game one. It's gonna be a good one, but I like Houston.
What's up? Thank you so much for watching ESPN on YouTube. Don't forget to download the ESPN app. And if you want more premium content, which you do, make sure that you subscribe to ESPN Plus. See you soon.